Our series, A More Perfect Union, aims to show that what unites us as Americans is far greater than what divides us. Many of us are discovering that it can take a superhuman effort to find an available dose of the COVID vaccine. In one Pennsylvania community, a pharmacist known as Dr. Mac and his superpower is helping saving lives. CBS News correspondent Nancy Chen explains.
Dr. Mac is responsible for these shots. This is the Superman who's responsible.
He's known as Dr. Mac, and his Superman costume is a Halloween leftover. But for the people at this pop-up vaccine clinic, Mayank Amin is the real deal.
We'll be back, so let your neighbors know.
Awesome. We appreciate you bringing it to us.
The pharmacist is vaccinating everyone he can in this community 45 minutes outside of Philadelphia, reaching more than 3,500 people in a day.
COVID-19 vaccines have been so tough to get, and when that UPS driver walked through that door and said, here are your vaccines, we were almost dancing, like getting ready to party, because this is what our town has been waiting for.
And now you're delivering your vaccines as Superman.
I continue to wear the Superman costume because of the responses that I've seen from the community. It doesn't require a child to see Superman to get some happiness or joy.
The center of his operation, this small independent pharmacy, until recently the only one in the town of Skipack offering vaccines.
We have one full-time employee and myself, two people to be able to administer 4,000 vaccines. On top of that, running a pharmacy is not something that's possible. But having an army of volunteers behind you, they're doing it because they love every single person in this community and because this is a community effort.
We're getting an email within the next 24 or 48 hours, so be looking for that.
400 people have signed up to man the phones and coordinate appointments with just 24 to 36 hours notice.
Once the vaccines come into our pharmacy and get put into the freezer, then it's time to move into action. We have to call and or email 1,000 people to let them know that the vaccines arrived.
This clinic was organized by his team at a community center in nearby Norristown, one of the county's hardest hit areas. Denise Ash is the center's CEO.
You see people one day and the next day, they have COVID, they're getting sick, and a lot of people we know have lost relatives.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Tanya Hall says she likely would have had to wait until May to get a vaccine.
We're done.
Because of her limited mobility.
I live right up the street, you know? It's really great to have something like this, close to home.
Thank you guys for being patient today.
From large clinics, vaccinating hundreds by the hour,
hello,
to visits at home, one at a time.
They pay you good money to put that outfit on.
9-year-old Joseph Dildine and his wife, Marsha.
That's it. You are fully vaccinated.
Yay.
Now closer to seeing their grandchildren without worry.
We're all huggers, 6 feet apart, and it just doesn't work. It's just not the same. It's a nice idea, but, you know, you can't hug them. And we miss that a lot.
The effort is paying off. The county now has one of the highest per capita vaccination rates in the state, a mission to help others in line with his faith.
My guru, and you see the red dot with the U here, that's a symbol of my faith. His motto is, in the joy of others lies our own. So anything that we do, if you're bringing somebody else joy, just do it.
How do you think the community will remember this?
I think our community absolutely loves the fact that their local superheroes banded together to do something that no one ever thought was possible.
For CBS This Morning, Nancy Chen, Skipack, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, it is a heroic effort. Dr. Mac says he's helped give out 22,000 vaccine doses since early February.